Hello there, ladies and gentlemen! Hello, hello, and welcome back to a few more episodes. We took a little break because Madnex's computer got broken and some shit, I don't know. But he paid some money and fixed it for me, so I don't care. I gotta record some shit, right? Metro, here we go. By the way, I tried to use a different recording system. It completely did not work, so I got ahead like a chapter or two, but we're gonna load the previous chapter so we can all play it together, you know what I mean? And by the way, I also have a fan behind me because it's fucking hot today, it's like 5000 degrees. Damn, I miss the winter, man. You people don't know what it means. So we finished with Cursed, and now we're going to the armory to meet Andrew the Smith. Let's go. Yes, yes.
Кузнецкий мост был необычной станцией. Он весь состоял из мастерских. Тут собирали большую часть оружия, обращавшегося в метро. Я искал Андрея Мастера, но он нашел меня первым.
I don't know why he did not mention the nukes, but they decided to write about some nukes. There was nothing about nukes. Or perhaps I'm mistaken. Okay. By the way, you might hear Frankie at the background meowing or what shit. What the hell was that? I saw a picture on the left. I must say though, now that I got myself a... upgrade on Madnex's computer, I can upgrade the view as well, so that's what I did basically. Don't remember if it's silenced or not. No, it's not. Okay. Do I need a mask? I don't think I need a mask. Okay, let's go in. Oh, what the hell was that? I need a flashlight. Flashlight is all I need in a tunnel. Okay, hello? I don't see anyone. Can I use this door? No. What does it say? Стой! Приход запрещен. Stop! Entrance is forbidden. Okay.
Стой! Кто идет? Не двигаться!
Окей.
Эй, расслабься! Это человек! Выключи свет! Ну да, выглядишь ты по-человечески. Это главное. Давай, заваливай. Это свободная станция.
Спасибо. Я иду. Я иду, it means I'm coming. Hello. Как дела, братаны?
Но ты поосторожнее тут. Станция у нас, конечно, свободная, но красные за нами приглядывают. Повсюду их агенты. Это не паранойя, парень, а осторожность. Так что держись поскромнее, понял?
Понял, понял.
Просто дружеский совет.
Спасибо.
Внимание! На станции проводится проверка документов. Всем пройти к месту своей прописки. Помогайте правоохранительным органам выполнять их работу.
Well, that was spazzy some shit out. Right, I am in a search of bullets. Graphics, can you stop spazzing out, please? It's kinda scary. I don't have a flashlight. When I got closer, I thought I have a flashlight, but I don't know what this light is. I don't have a flashlight. Can I run? Yes, I can run. Okay. Oh, hello. You almost escaped me, Mr. Bullet. Hey there, sir. You have bullets for free? No? You never do, you bastards. Hello.
Лицом к стене! Обыск!
Да хватит, отстаньте, противные! Я не такой!
Заткни хлебало!
Готов, командиру сейчас не до тебя, пацан.
Всегда готов.
А скажите, доктор, раз вы уже там, не могли бы вы заглянуть и к моей простате? А то как не пойду по нужде, ну все светит.
Потише.
Может, облучился?
ГБ следит за нами.
Мерзавец!
Ай! Бьешь по тем частям тела, которые покорили твое воображение! Бьешь слабовато, однако!
I go in here?
Так, а ты кто? Напарник? Он рыжий клоун, а ты белый? Ты тоже арестован.
Ладно, ладно, ладно. Только без рук. Я сам пойду.
Стой, стрелять буду!
Беги!
You fucker.
Ах ты,
дрянь! I don't want to be in this shit.
За мной, парень!
Хватайте, ублюдка!
Вперёд, быстрее!
Fucking bitch. It's all your fault. I'm coming. Okay. Ouch. I'm coming, you bastard. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Я не верю в Бога. Но в тот день за меня больше некому было вступиться. И меня спасли. Друг Хана, Андрей Мастер. Только он смог помочь мне выбраться с этой станции.
Проблема в том, что единственный путь проходит через линию фронта между красными и фашистами. Тебе потребуется маскировка. Возьми этот комбинезон, натянешь поверх одежды. Красные сейчас вербуют добровольцев, чтобы штурмовать фашистские укрепления. Как только наберут полный состав пушечного мяса, сразу отправят его на передовую. Можешь поехать на этом поезде зайцем. Не в первом классе, конечно. Но и платить кровью не придется. Как только поезд минует блокпосты, ты свободен.
Окей, спасибо. By the way, Artyom said, I don't believe in God, and not if there is a God. But never mind. Oh, hello, Bullet. I saw you shining. Shining a light on me. Hey there, sir. Just sitting there, looking at me. How you doing? All good, man? Man. Hello, you have bullets? No? No one has bullets, damn them. Anybody home? Hello? No, nobody home. Hello, lady. How you doing? Lady? Okay. I guess she doesn't like me. Запасной выход. An extra exit. Well, запасной, it's like... I'm not sure if extra is the word for it, but it's like... When you put something on a side, so you will have, in case you will lose something, that you have a backup, I guess a backup exit. But backup exit sounds so weird.
Граница с фашистами на замке, на каждом ходе блокпосты, крысы не проскочат.
А что с поверхностью? Эти гады наверняка пронюхали, как можно напасть на нас сверху. А их пятая колонна тем временем разлагает наш народ, готовит вторжение.
Очень хорошо. Всех новоприбывших на станцию мы тогда будем направлять в обезьянники отсиживаться. Ваши люди сами решат, кто шпион, а кто нет.
Wow. They want to send every newcoming to this station to the quote Gestapo end quote.
Можешь осмотреть магазины, купить что тебе надо, но не трать время зря. Поезд отойдет точно по расписанию. Тебя ждать он не станет.
Окей. So they want to check who is kosher and who is not, so to speak. Hello, sir.
Налетай, разбирай.
Can you upgrade my collage?
их совсем немного осталось.
Вот. А он...
Для тебя берег.
А, да он тут...
Пользоваться просто. Берешь и стреляешь.
Customize, sorry. You can make it a sniper rifle. I think. If I want. This is a night vision. Night vision couldn't be good. You know what, I go for normal for now. Yeah? Should I go for normal? Sure. No. Let's go for night vision. I like night vision. It's like, you know, it's... I like it. Fuck it. Night vision, go. And of course silencer. Because I'm a stealthy motherfucker. What is this? Laser sight. Should I go for... No, I don't have monies. One second, I'll be right back. Hello, sir.
Пульки, пульки, пульки. Меняем пульки.
Пульки, пульки, hello. I have these arrows.
Да тебе складывать все это добро некуда.
Oh, sorry. I want to sell. There you go.
Ну и где твои патроны?
And I have this.
Я вот свои выложил. Ну и где твои патроны?
And I have shotgun.
Свои выложил. Эй, у тебя такого калибра-то нет?
Okay, I buy some this. Well, bullets. I buy some this. Sure, that's it.
Отличная сделка.
And now I go upgrade my collage.
Спецпредложения, скидки, лучшие пушки от лучших мастеров.
Yes. Nice. Thank you, sir. And you?
Аптечки, фильтры, ножи. Набор туриста.
I buy flammable. Sure, I buy two flammable.
Отличный курс.
Thank you, sir. Okay, I'm all set. I'm ready to go.
Все нормально, мужики. Он со мной.
Hi.
Давай, Артём, прыгай в яму.
Okay. Sure thing. Oh, hello. Bullet. Damn it, somebody call me, be right back. Okay, nothing important. Let's continue. Turn it off. Who? Who? Where are they? Oh, okay. Wait, are you gonna bury me? I'm still alive.
Артём, видишь там багажное отделение? Забирайся туда.
Окей. Метро 2034. That's the next step of метро.
Ну так что, мужики? Двинули, а?
Окей. I guess двинули.
Если он останется на станции, он точно труп. Потому что билет на Лубянку, он только в один конец.
That's a little bit encouraging. Either die or perhaps die.
Все нормально, подбирайте. Все в норме. Теперь все зависит от тебя.
I can barely hear anything. Is it just me? Well, they don't have different tracks for sounds and for voices, which is very annoying. Are we ready to go or what? Oh, before we do that, read diary. So, armory. As you probably can see, already got the front line as well. We'll read it later. There are many in the metro who hate the Reds, because they are afraid of them. The Reds always go hungry, even though they work round the clock. They are told they toil for a better future, but year after year, their lives get even more miserable. They fight with abandon as if not afraid of death at all, and their comrades just throw them away. Okay. Piling their bodies up to block enemy. Gun emplacements? What? So they're piling their bodies up to block enemy gun emplacements. I don't know what that means. Gun emplacements? Like when you place what's an emplace? Place guns somewhere? What? Spending their lives as if their charges were immortal. But they are mortal, and they die of exhaustion, of overworking, of bullets fired at by their enemies, and their own commissar's order to shoot those retreating. They are told they are superior, that they are made of steel, not flesh. And that is why I pity them. What do they live and die for? The idols of the past and long gone? But they are kept in the dark about it. The slogans they communicate with are meaningless in the new world. They are prohibited from speaking or even thinking freely. Anyone asking questions is deemed a traitor. Anyone who says life's better outside the red line is a spy and a saboteur. You have to hide everything human about you and become just like the rest of them. But there are also people like Andrew the blacksmith here. People who refuse to abandon hope and who preserve. If I were in his shoes, I'd be long gone. Why is he still here? Is he afraid of being shot making his escape? Okay, number 2. I was not wrong about Andrew. I just grossly underestimated him. He is not afraid of running. He just goes. He just does things that take much more guts than that. Andrew helps others escape the red line, risking his own life every minute. He and his friends saved lots of refugees using a network of abandoned passages and forgotten tunnels, which the Reds are still ignorant about. The refugees usually take this literal and at the same time figurative underground railroad to get from the Red Line to the metro proper. To the metro proper? Okay. But for me, Andrew is working it in reverse. I need to get to the front lines of the never-ending war between the Red Line and the Reich. I'm taking the train which is delivering a flesh load of cannon fodder to the meat grinder. The important part is to know when to jump off.